Welcome to a how-to on integrating Courseplay with AutoDrive. So let's dive in and see how this goes. So for the purposes of this how-to, we are on Attingham Park. So I did a Let's Play on here and it's got quite an extensive AutoDrive course, and I've actually done this integration within the Let's Play. So I have, for the purposes of the video, increased the scale of the AutoDrive hood so you can hopefully see better as to what we are doing. So we've got ourselves a lovely Fendt 1050 Bergman manure spreader, put my teeth back in, and we are going to spread manure on field 34. So let's just have a quick look at the map. So we are down here at the main yard, and this is field 34 here. So what I'm going to do first, because I have tested this, because it's always wise to test things before you try and teach people how to do things. So first things first, we have got field 34 weight set. Now, we important to note, we are in the load category within AutoDrive, so you just click on the icon next to the start button and you tab through until you get to load. Select your weight point, so field 34 weight, that's the target for the tractor and the implement to go to. Next, we need to have a load station, so we're going to take the manure from the manure plate or pit, and this will pick itself up automatically. This is the crop type, so manure. Right, so we've done that. We've got the lines on, as you can see. So if we just turn those off for a second, you'll see some of the icons disappear, but this Courseplay one appears instead. So that is important. We need that in a minute. So now we need to generate the course in the field. So this is the Courseplay element of this tutorial. So if we create a job, we want to be, let's just move this out the way a little bit. There we go. Get rid of that. Now you can see we're on Courseplay fieldwork, and you can get to that by just clicking either one of the arrows until you get there. We want field position, and we are going to just click anywhere in that field, and you can see the white line highlights the field. Target position. Now, ideally, you would set this after your start point just to make it easier for the tractor and the implement to navigate to that point. So we'll go for here and we will just click like that. Now, down here, open, close course generator. We're going to open that, scroll back up to the top, and you can see course generator settings of the 1050. So the Fendt, it's picked up the working width, two headlands. You can do as many or as little as you want. All the rest is for you to choose how you want to set it up. We will generate the course. There we go. Close that. And you can see, for some annoying reason, it's put the start point down here, but that is fine. So now we can just come out of that menu. And this is where we now need to click the Courseplay icon, so you can see that the yellow part of the icon shows up, so that means it is on. We can now click go, engine will start, and it should edge past. Let's put the course on. There we go. It'll drive down to the manure point. As I said, this is quite an extensive course, so it is difficult to see where it's going to end up. There we go, just edging round. And it'll start filling in a second. There we go. So that'll fill itself up. Quite a quick fill, so jobs are good in there. And then what it'll do is now it's going to go to, you can see it's activated onto, let me show you with the cursor, field 34 weight. So that'll drive to the field point, and then we'll catch up when it gets there. So just pulling into field 34, and what it's going to do is it's going to drive to the weight point, and you'll notice then, did you see? The driver has actually swapped, so that is now in course play mode. So what it's going to do now is drive to where it's going to start. Going to get unfolded. Now, it will turn on a little bit prematurely, but that's fine. There we go. Now it'll start flinging the muck. There we go. So I'll tell you what, we'll turn that off. Just minimise the HUD for a second. And you'll see it's now working around the field on horseplay. Simple as that, he says. So now once this is empty, it should, if you've got, it should remember where it stopped. Now, if you're unsure, you can always just make sure that it's set to last waypoint. Now that means when it stops, it knows that it needs to go back to where it was last. It's not the last waypoint as in the last point on the course, it's the last point that the tractor registered in the field. Okay, so we'll let that empty and we'll go watch it refill. So last 1,000 litres, and I'm on this view, so what you'll see in a second is the worker has changed. So that's now back onto auto drive, and now it's thinking, right, I need to go to the weight point. There we go. And then it was going to drive from that weight point back to the manure, get refilled, and then it'll come back to the field and it'll start again. So it's just navigating its way to the course. Hopefully. So yeah, if we put the course on, look, we've got a course running around the outside of the field, which then takes it back to the weight point, which it will do a loop, exit, and go and refill. So I'll catch you back at the yard. So as you can see, the tractor is back at the manure fill point, found its way here on its own. That'll now get refilled, and it'll head back to the field. It'll pick up where it left off, crosses his fingers, and then it'll just rinse and repeat until that whole field is done, till it completes the course play course. So once again, we'll head back to the field and we'll pick up where it left off before. So we've reached the field 34 weight point, and now the worker is going to navigate its way back to the last waypoint. Now it's very difficult to see where we've been with the manure unless you're sort of at that kind of angle, but reassured, it's going to go back to where it was. There you go, it's picked it up. You can just about see the texture difference there. So it'll unfold, get onto the course, and it'll continue. Now I'm not quite sure how it's going to handle the corner down here, so we may need to intervene, but that's just the shape of the field. So there you go, back on the course, last waypoint, turns on, job's a good one. And you can see from the fertiliser map that it hasn't missed anything from where it stopped. So that, in a nutshell, is how you integrate Courseplay with AutoDrive. It's important to know that you need to have a reasonably good AutoDrive course, and I'm not going to cover that now. There are people far better at AutoDrive courses than me to show you how to do that. That's now going to move on to the second headland. There you go. And like I said before, it's rinse and repeat. It'll keep doing that until the course play course is finished. So I hope you found that useful and helpful. Any questions, feel free to jump into my Discord. The link is in the video description below. It's a lot easier to help with issues, problems on Discord rather than in YouTube comments. So yeah, if you've enjoyed the video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and I will catch you in the next one. Take care.